Hi, in this video I am going to discuss about types of combustion chamber. First of all, we need to know what is combustion chamber. So combustion chamber is nothing but a chamber where the combustion process occurs inside the gas turbine engine. So these combustion chambers looks like a space in between the compressor and turbine where the combustion process takes place. The combustion process inside the combustion chamber is a continuous process which will be takes place at high pressure and high temperature in smaller space. There are some basic requirements for the combustor. The first basic requirement will be pressure loss. The pressure loss should be minimum as possible because we are considering a gas turbine engine to takes place combustion at constant pressure, so that the pressure loss will be minimum as possible. And then the second requirement will be combustion efficiency should be high at different operating conditions. At different flight conditions, the combustion efficiency should be high as possible. Thirdly, the outlet temperature distribution should be uniform so that the turbine blades should not be affected by local overheating. There are some basic components inside the combustor. The first one will be a snout. Snout is nothing but a passage where the primary air enters into the combustion chamber. And then we have swirl vanes. Swirl vanes are used to make turbulence of the inlet air to mix the fuel with air. And then there will be some interconnectors. Interconnectors are used to connect two or more cans or another combustion chambers. And then there will be a primary zone. Primary zone where the maximum temperature takes place, where the initial combustion process will start. And then we have a flame tube. Flame tube is nothing but a inner chamber where the real combustion occurs. And then we have a air casing. Air casing is used to supply secondary air and tertiary air for cooling and dilution purposes. And then we have sealed ring to seal the combustion chamber inside the gas turbine engine. Next, we will discuss about the combustion process. So the combustion process will be consisting of the following four steps. So first step will be injection of fuel droplets and then mixing that fuel droplets with the air. So in the first step, it enters into the snout where the fuel droplets are injected by fine spray atomizers or injectors, and then it will be mixes with the compressed air coming from the compressor. In the second step, the fuel droplets will be vaporized in air. The compressed air will have some temperatures to vaporize the fuel droplets. And in the third step, there will be a breaking down of heavy hydrocarbons into lighter fractions where the heavier hydrocarbon components will be decomposed or broken down into lighter fractions. At the final step, there will be intimate mixing of these hydrocarbon molecules with the oxygen molecules, and then the chemical reaction will start, the combustion process will take place. In the combustion process, the air enters the combustor will be divided into three categories. First one will be the primary zone where the 20% of the main flow will enters, where the real combustion occurs. In the primary zone, the fuel droplets will mix with the air, and that the temperature produced by the combustion will be very high. And then we have a secondary zone. The secondary zone where the incomplete combustion products will be mixed with the secondary air, and the complete combustion occurs at the secondary zone. And in the tertiary zone, there will be 60% of the main flow air enters into the tertiary zone. So where the temperature of the gases will be reduced by means of air which enters into the tertiary zone. So the tertiary zone acts as a cooling zone where the temperature of the gases will be reduced, and these reduced temperature of the gases will enter the turbine. The combustion chambers used in gas turbine engines are classified into three different types. First one will be can, second one will be annular, third one will be cannular. These three types are classified based on the shape and configurations. Now we are going to discuss about these three types in detail. Can combustors are also known as tubular combustor, where we have multiple cylindrical cans which will be spaced around the space in between the compressor and turbine. So these can will have separate air stream injectors and igniters, where we have a separate combustion chamber or a pressure vessel where the combustion process takes place inside the can separately. So these separately combusted combustion products are get into the mainstream to the turbine by means of a exhaust diffuser. So the advantages of CAN combustors are we can easy to test. So these CAN combustors are separate combustion chamber, we can easily test separately, and then it is easy to maintain. When we have some problem within the CAN combustor, we can separately remove that CAN combustor and we can repair it and we can fix it later. The disadvantages of CAN combustor will be having higher pressure loss, and then weight will be quite larger as compared to other types. Next will be annular combustors. These annular combustors are simple in construction, which has a liner which mounted concentrically inside annular casing where the combustion process will take place. It looks like a ring like structure which looks like a similar to a furnace, which uses a maximum space available for combustion process within the space between the compressor and turbine, and it permits a good mixing of fuel and air. The advantages of annular combustor is low weight as compared to CAN and cannular combustors, and the disadvantages will be it will be difficult to test, maintain and repair. If we have a repair in the annular combustor, we need to dismantle the engine and we need to repair the combustor, and it is difficult to maintain some stable outlet temperature from the combustor, because in the annular combustor the combustion process will not be uniform as compared to CAN type combustor. Cannular combustor is a combination of both CAN and annular combustion chamber, which have advantages of both the combustor. It consists of a series of CANs arranged with a common single annulus, where the combustion process takes place within the CANs and also within the annulus. These CANs are no more act as a pressure vessel, which are interconnected with each and every CANs, and it will open to supply some fuel or mixture within the annulus too. And the pressure loss will be low as compared to CAN type combustor. But the cannular combustor is difficult to design and manufacture because of its complexity. Thank you all for listening the lecture. If you have any doubt in combustion chamber,